The Algarve is well known for its warm climate, beautiful beaches and golf courses. But there's so much more to discover here. I've joined a Travel Editions escorted tour, aptly named Authentic Algarve, which aims to uncover a different but equally appealing side to this hugely popular region of Portugal. Our tour manager, Ellen, told me more about the design of this tour.
I've been travelling to the Algarve for over 40 years and I felt that it was an ideal time to showcase the authentic side of the Algarve to our travellers who tend to like to go off the beaten track, which this tour very much does do. Tavira is the perfect place to be based for this tour because the location means that we're able to carry out all the visits without too much time being spent on the coach. The actual town of Tavira itself, full of history, a lot of Moorish influence here, and the hotel is located within 5 minutes of numerous restaurants for everybody to be able to go out on their free evenings and wander around and soak up the atmosphere in what is a very authentic town that has not been commercialised at all.
The tour is based at the four-star Villa Gale Hotel, a large hotel by Travel Editions standards, with comfortable rooms, a lovely outdoor pool, buffet-style dining, a large bar and a spa with indoor pool and gym. Conveniently close to the town, our first outing was to explore Tavira on foot with local guide Luis. Having got our bearings, the group quickly warmed to Tavira, especially the many options available for dining out in the evenings.
Tavira is really, really nice. Everything is so close and accessible. There's a big number of restaurants. We enjoyed one meal so much, we had to go back two nights later for exactly the same thing.
If we had to be placed in a town, that would be the one I'd choose. I think Tavira had everything.
It's not commercialised.
Authentic food.
Authentic food.
Nice wines.
The tour includes 5 full-day excursions, each focusing on a combination of nature, culture and history. Every town in this region has a story to tell, and an understanding of the historical timeline is essential to appreciate the context. So we're here now at Silves Castle, one of the most important monuments in this area. And we get to see quite a lot of history in the course of the tour, in the company of Luis, our lovely guide. Luis, just give us an overview of the historical layers that we get to see.
So here in Silves was definitely a settlement before Roman arrived here. There is clear archaeological evidence of that. With the arrival of the Romans, this place started to develop. And after them, the Visigoths also have been around here. But the biggest development of the area was happening with the Arabs arriving. They have been ruling this area, developing this area, developing the agriculture, developing all kind of urban life around here. And this place was taken by the Portuguese force, or was completed, the taking of this place in the year of 1249. We can see the presence of the Moorish culture and architecture in the buildings, in the monuments, and in the layout of the cities and the streets.
Balanced with the history, much of the itinerary focused on enjoying the surrounding nature and bird life that thrives in the salt pans and wetlands. Luis's knowledge and insights added an extra dimension to all our outings, something the group clearly appreciated.
His level of expertise is highly academic in certain regards, particularly when it comes to botany, I think.
Luis is very good. His enthusiasm
and his passion for birds and plants and his own country and his own locality.
This is not a full-on walking holiday, but there are several opportunities to explore the contrasting landscapes of the region on foot. One more challenging walk, especially in the unseasonably warm April weather, took us up to the Cerro da Cabeça for wonderful views back down to the coast.
And today we've taken the longest drive from the hotel up to Serra de Montchique, which is actually the highest point in the Algarve. Of course, the higher you come, the more spectacular the views.
On the full day excursions, a group lunch is included.
And the menu always focuses on local specialities. In this case, catalana, which is not the food, it's actually the dish that it's cooked in. Looks amazing.
So we explored on land, but no trip to the Algarve would be complete without taking to the water. Tavira Island is easily accessible by ferry.
If you're craving the beach, it's a short hop on the ferry over from the town to Tavira Island, where you've got this magnificent stretch of white sand. It's just perfect for walking.
And on a private group boat trip from Olhão, we explored the other barrier islands, wetlands and marshes that make up the protected Rio Formosa Natural Park.
Well, as we're going along, obviously everything is a very low level, but it's a hive of activity. We've seen oyster farms, people digging for clams, people fishing. We just saw someone catch an octopus.
And we got to go ashore and see local fishermen unpick their catch.
Eye-opening what's here, the nature and whatnot, because I don't golf and I don't go to the beach, so I wouldn't have come for that. So it's been fascinating.
I think they organise things really well, and you know where you are with them, you know, you get quality.
People who come on these holidays, we've got a similar background, and we come expecting to mix very well together, and that is always the case. It's fantastic.
This really is a perfect tour for those who get the appeal of a warm Algarve climate, but whose interests lie in history, culture and nature. Fully escorted with included excursions and group meals, but also free time and the flexibility to dine out independently in the evenings. This really is a very sociable and, most important of all, stress-free way to travel.